Welcome back. Today we want to discuss one more problem on welded connection, time member design using single angle and fillet bend. Here is the problem statement: a time member consisting of an ISA Indian standard angle, 80 mm, 50 mm, 80 mm, FE4 tempered steel is welded to a 12 mm thick gusset plate at site. Design weld to transmit load equal to the design strength of the member. If you observe here, they not given the factor load to be transmitted through the joint. They are given indirectly that how much load factor force you need to design, that is equal to the design strength of the member. So first we should calculate the design strength of the member. That value itself, the factored load. For that factored load, we need to design the welded connection here. So we know for Fe 410 grade steel, Fu is 410 MPa, Fy is 250, gamma MW 1.5. For sight or fillet weld from table number 5, gamma M0 is 1.10 from table number 5. So here first we need to calculate the factored load, that is nothing but design strength of the member. This one we need to calculate according to 6.2 of IS 82.7. If this is the formula TDG HE Fy by gamma M0. So here if you look into the code, this is the formula design strength of the member due to yielding of the grass section. This is the formula. Fy is 250, we know gamma M0 is 1.1 from table number 5. We should know the cross section area of the angle to substitute here. For that we need to look into steel tables or SP6 part 1. Here I have taken from Agor steel table tables. So here we need to go for roll load steel unequal angles, since they given in a problem 80 mm is one leg, 50 mm is other leg, thickness is 80. Since it is unequal leg, we need to go for this table number 2. So here this is our ISA 80 50 into 80. 80 is what? Is nothing but thickness of the angle. So we want sectional area, cross sectional area here 9.78. The unit is centimeter square. So if you convert into millimeter square, you will go to get what? 978. If you convert centimeter square to millimeter square, the cross sectional area of the member from SP6, if you write, there is 978 millimeter square. I will come back to this figure later. Now if you substitute here the formula, you will going to get 222.22 kilonewton. This is the factored load. For this we need to design the member. That is, therefore the welded will be designed to transmit the force equal to this load. In exam they may give directly the external force like 300 kilonewton, 400, something like that they will give. Here we calculate indirectly by calculating the strength of the member. Now our job is to calculate what? The size of the weld, how much we need to use the size and length of the weld. So here this is the figure I have written here. If you see this is the model I am showing now. This is gusset plate, this is angle. Here they not mention, we have option to weld here one side, two side, top, bottom, here and below this plate angle we can provide. But they not mention anything. I will going to provide only top and bottom, two sides of welding. This is the model. So we want to connect like this to the gusset plate. If you connect like this, this is what? The gusset plate. This is also gusset plate. I have written in another view. So here this is welding. I projected here. This is top welding. This is bottom welding. So the next question is, how much I need to provide top weld length and how much I need to provide bottom weld length. So here the external force is acting along this section is the steel or the angle is P, that is in our case 222.27 kilonewton. Always this P will go to act through the centroid of the angle section. Now the question is, where is the centroid for the angle? Out of 80, where will going to get? That will going to get at a distance of C center from bottom, that is 27.3 millimeter. This value we need to look in a steel table. So center of gravity CXX, that is from here, if you see the figure here, from here to here. Okay, CXX value in our case is 2.73 centimeter in steel table they given. If you convert into millimeter, we're going to get 27.3 millimeter. If it is 27.3 millimeter, remaining value will be what? 52.7. Total will be 80 millimeter. So now we located what? Center of gravity. Along this center of gravity, the P will going to act external force. So here, this P, external force, will be equal to what? Resistance offered by the welding. So the I have taken P1 as a resistive force offered by LW1, P2 is a resistive force offered by LW2. So P becomes what? P will be equal to, at any stage, P1 plus P2. These two will going to balance this force by giving proper resistance here. So now our question is to calculate S value, LW1 and LW2. So now, here I have taken two sections, 1-1 at top weld, 2-2 at bottom weld. So now, here, by taking moment of P1, P2 and P, three forces here, okay, at along section 1-1, for equilibrium of joint, if you take moment, I have taken clockwise moment is positive. I will show how to take moment here. So in along this section 1-1, about this section 1-1, P1 is into 0. Why P1 is passing through this section 0? This will become clockwise P2, P2 into depth of the section 80 millimeter. P3 becomes what? Anticlockwise force. So anticlockwise moment, P into this value height. What is that? 52.7. I have written here. Why I am doing all these things? To calculate the P1 and P2. If you know P1 and P2, correspondingly we can calculate LW1 and LW2. Here this becomes 0. This value we know already, 222.27. So here we are going to get P2. If you know P2 here, then calculate what? P1. So P1 becomes what? P minus P2. That is 75.85 kilonewton. So now we know these two values. Just we need to calculate what length of the weld ring. So we know the formula, strength or load carrying capacity of the weld equal to what? Area of the weld into stress. In area we have LW1 into K into S. K value we can choose from the table, that's a code book. S value we need to choose. Since it is a first problem, I will show how to take S value. So the minimum size of the fillet weld we need to choose from table number 21. If you see table number 21 in the code book here, minimum size of the first run of the weld is depends on thickness of the thicker part in millimeter. So in our case, they give an angle thickness 8 mm and cassette bed thickness 12 mm, whichever is higher, that is 12 mm is higher, that falls in between 10 to 20 over up to 20. Therefore we need to take 5 mm as minimum size according to the code. So then the thing is the maximum size, how much we need to take. So the maximum we need to take from 10.5.8.1, and that will varies for sharp edge and round edge. If you see here this cassette plate and this angle, they're meeting at 90 degree sharp edge, whereas here we're going to get round edge along this line. So we're going to get different S max value. So according to code, if you choose here for sharp order, so square edge, what is the S max we can provide? By design considerations, by effective transfer of force consideration, we need to take for square edge thickness of this edge minus 1.5 will be S maximum. For curved edge, thickness of the angle minus 1/4. So I've taken here that value. For sharp edge, here cassette plate is sharp edge, having cassette plate, having sharp edge, edge, for that thickness is 12. If you deduct 1.5, it's going to be 10.5. For round edge, we know the thickness is 8 millimeter. So here we need to deduct 1/4 by design consideration. Here you're going to get 3/4 into 8. So I am planned to give on top and bottom same size of the weld, Therefore, better we need to choose what 6 mm size as a maximum size of the weld. So this theory is available in class section 10.5.8.1 in the code book and 10.5.8.2. So now I'm choosing 6 mm is the size of the weld. So now we know the formula, that is load carrying capacity or strength equal to area of the weld into stress. For P1, substitute P1 for P1 value here, calculate LW1. So here we need to choose what field, gamma MW for field weld or site weld. For P2, this is the formula, substitute the value of P2 here, 146 kN. So I would substitute here in terms of what? Newtons. Since Fu in terms of Newton, we're going to get answer in millimeter. So this is what LW1, LW2 we need to provide on the top and bottom side of the weld. Here, top side we need to provide 115 millimeter, LW2 is 221 millimeter. So now in exam they may ask to provide three sets of welding. If you see the figure here, they may ask to provide three sets of welding like this, top, bottom and here along the depth, and we have option to provide here also below this member. So in the exam, if they ask to provide three sets of welding, directly we can say the length of this weld. What is the length of this weld? It's nothing but length of the leg. In our case, what is this value? 80 millimeter. So I've extended this problem. I extended this problem to three sets of welding. So here we need to calculate what? LW1, LW2 and LW3. LW3 is already known, 80 millimeter. What is total? First here in this type of problem, first we need to calculate what? The total length of the weld required. So by using this P value, that is external factor force, as using this formula, calculate LW. What is LW? Total length of the weld required to transmit the load. That will be equal to what? LW1 for top weld, LW2 and LW3. So we can tell directly LW3 is 80 millimeter. Okay. Now we need to take moment of all these forces about 1-1. Why we need to take moment? To calculate what? LW1 and LW2. That is our target. If you take about section 1-1 about top edge, P1 into 0 plus P2 into 80 plus P3 into 80 by 2. This is, P2 into 80 clockwise. P3, this will be acting exactly at the middle. P3 into length of the leg by 2, that is in our case 80 by 2 minus P. This is anticlockwise moment. P is P into 52.7, that is this value by deducting C6. So now in this formula, this part becomes 0. Okay. So P2, for P2, you better substitute the original formula. What is the formula? This one, LW2 TT FU root 3 by gamma MW. Here you substitute L2 in terms of L2 the formula. Here we know already the value 80. Better substitute this will become what? Determined portion. We can calculate directly since we know already L3 value. What is L3? L3 is 80 millimeter. So P, substitute the value of external load, in our case 222. Only unknown here is what? LW2. Only unknown here is LW2. So from this equation, okay, after simplifying this, calculate LW2. Okay. Now, so since we already know LW3 as 80 millimeter, LW2 from this equation, we calculate total length of the weld required for the external force. Then calculate LW1 equal to total length of the weld LW minus LW2 minus LW3, that is 80 millimeter. We're going to get that value 75 mm. So like this we can solve in exam if they ask to provide the weld on three sides of the angle. Thank you very much.